Hello, we're going to be looking at data types now, the five data types on the course, and also look at what casting means. So just a bit of background on what a data type is, because I can recall being really confused by this as a concept back when I was a student, and I really tried to overcomplicate it in my mind, which you don't need to do for this topic. So data types are just categories of different values which are being used in a program. We as humans like to categorize stuff generally, but this is especially important for computing because despite every value, every bit of data needing to be stored in binary, there are different ways to store it. You know, how we store it really varies based on what category it is. So by this I mean, well, text data, which we're going to call a string, will be stored using most likely Unicode, right? ASCII and Unicode are our two big character sets. You learnt this in paper one. Unicode is the one we use nowadays. So if I have text data in a computer, it will be stored using the Unicode character set. If I want to store the text hello, it just converts it to binary using the Unicode table. So the Unicode table says that H is equal to this, and it converts it like that. Whereas if I had some numerical data, which we're going to call either a real or an integer, this will most likely be converted using the similar sort of methods you learn in paper one, where you'd convert it using place value. Here is 11 in binary. This is how 11 would get stored if it was a number in a computer. So we have data types because the data type is going to determine how it is stored. The computer needs to know how to store it, if it's text, Unicode, if it's numbers, using a kind of binary place value. But also this relates to the operators it can work with. So we'll look at different operators in a couple of videos time. But for example, addition can be done using numerical data, and concatenation can be done using text data. Both actually have the same symbol, which is a plus. For the purpose of paper two, there are five data types you've got to know by name. So the integer data type is a category for any whole number. 8, 35 are whole numbers, minus 7 is a whole number. It just has no fractional part. A real, on the other hand, is a number which does have a fractional part. And again, this will get stored in binary using a different method to what you've learned. At GCSE, you've just learned how to convert integers into binary. To convert reals into binary, that is covered at A level. Now, if you've learned Python, you won't be calling these reals, you'll be calling these floats. If you want to use the word float in the exam, it's perfectly fine, but expect to see the word real. The word real refers to a float. The Boolean data type, most commonly we think of it as being either true or false. To give it a slightly broader definition, we can say it's one of two possible values. I'm going slightly broader because one is often used instead of true, and zero is often used instead of false. So therefore it could be those values, but typically Boolean think true or false. A character is a letter, number, or symbol in your character set. So in Unicode, in ASCII, it's not only letters. We also can have numbers being represented as a character. Likewise, symbols. If it has quotation marks around it, it is a character. And the word string is used to refer to text data. A string is just a sequence of characters. So more than one makes it a string. Again, if you've got quotation marks, either single or double quotation marks, this makes it a string. The fun thing to look at is casting, which is quite forgettable in paper two. It's something you have got to know. So casting as a definition is changing the data type of a value. So when do we have to do this? Well, almost always regarding user input in some way. And this is because user input is a string by default. No matter what the user types in, it's treated like it is a string. And if I want to use it as a number, perhaps in a calculation, I need to cast it to be either an integer or a float. So here's how we do this, right? Here, I've got a variable called quantity. I'm assigning it to be user input. So I'm asking the user how many items do they want. The number of items I'm assuming is a whole number. So therefore I'm converting it, I'm casting it to be an integer. I do this by sticking int at the front, adding an opening bracket, and adding a closing bracket at the end. It's converting whatever is in brackets to an integer. To do the same with a real, I just stick the word real. So int is shorthand for integer, obviously, but real we write out, and same process. The price is probably going to be a fractional number because we've got pence as well as pounds. And so therefore I'm converting it to be a real. If you wanted to use the word float like you would in Python, that's obviously fine. These two examples are our most common ways of casting. Don't forget to do it. You typically get a mark if you had to do that in a question. But we may also need to cast to a string occasionally. The reason why you might do this is if you're wanting to use a number in a print line, you can either use a comma to separate variables. You also can concatenate. We'll look at what that word means in a future video in more detail. But here, I've got cost as a variable using quantity and price. It's a calculation. There needs to be numbers to do this. But if I want to put it in a print line and combine it with a string, I need to convert this number into a string. So I've put str, again, short for string. This is our casting function, which is converting quantity into a string. I'm also converting cost into a string. Having all of these things as strings means I can use the plus symbol, which concatenates and puts together these different values. I could have used a comma to separate these, but the downside is I would have got a space after my pound sign. So you might want to do this to make it a little bit cleaner.